This is a filter bubble. It's your own personal, unique universe of information that you live in online. And what's in your bubble depends on who you are and what you do. But the thing is, you don't decide what gets in, and you don't get to see what gets edited out. I first noticed this on my Facebook page. I'm progressive, politically, but I've always gone out of my way to meet conservatives. I like hearing what they're thinking about, seeing what they link to, and learning a thing or two. I noticed one day that the conservatives had disappeared from my newsfeed. Facebook saw that I was clicking more on my liberal friends' links than my conservative friends' links, and without consulting me, it had removed them altogether. Facebook is not the only one doing this. Even if you're logged out, there are 57 signals that Google looks at. Everything from what kind of computer you're on, to what kind of browser you're using, to where you're located. Think about it for a second. There is no standard Google anymore. You can't see how different your search results are from anyone else's. There is a passing of the torch from human gatekeepers to algorithmic ones, and these algorithms don't yet have the kind of embedded ethics that editors do. So if algorithms are going to curate the world for us and decide what we get to see and what we don't get to see, then we need to make sure that they're not just keyed to relevance, but also things that are uncomfortable, challenging, and important. We the users need to have some control to decide what gets through and what doesn't, because we need the internet to be that thing that we all dreamed of it being. We need it to connect us all together, to introduce us to new ideas, new people, different perspectives. And it's not going to do that if it leaves us all isolated in a web of one.